Bout number 13 is a semi-professional bout fought in the heavyweight division. Fought over three-minute rounds. Introducing firstly, representing Essex MMA, Matt Fuhr!
Number 13, we have the big boys at 100 kilograms. This will be a semi-pro mixed martial arts bout held at three-minute rounds. Out of Team Rampage, in the red corner, Paul Webster. And out of the blue corner, Matt Fuhr, out of Essex MMA.
This fight's been matched by promoter Gavin Robinson. This is Lords of the Cage, myself, Danny Kendrick, and the infamous Pierre in the commentary box.
Oh, huge right, whoa. Matt Fuhr on his butt. Now that was like two raging bulls straight from the bell.
They came here to fight, Pierre.
And I tell you what, Paul Webster with that straight right down the pipe with an exclamation point, putting down Matt Fuhr with his back to the mat.
I know this guy, Webster, we went to match the guy with the promoter, Gavin Robinson. We went to the gym and matched them up for this fight. And nice guy, I know he's really fired up for this. It's his actual debut fight, so he's really, really looking forward to that. What stage to have a fight at Lords of the Cage to come and do it here.
Now you can see the reddening on Matt Fuhr's eye where that was straight right from Webster just connected. Webster posturing up, looking to throw some leather.
Yeah, almost ground and pound there. And there's blood pouring from his nose here. That shot was good. Referee Lee Catnell wants the doctors and the corner to clear that up.
Now I'll tell you what. Webster was more than ready to let it stand back up onto the feet. He wanted to throw some weather. Ladies and gentlemen, I'll tell you what, this guy came here and he is ready for a scrap.
I'll tell you what, Essex MMA representing over there in the corner, and their guys have had to attend to his nose. He'll find it hard to breathe out of there now. A lovely shot on the button there. Webster's loving this fight now. He looks like he's really enjoying himself in there, Pierre.
Yeah, Fuhrer earlier tried a double leg. However, Webster saw it coming a mile away and was able to peel it off. And now Webster on the back foot with Fuhrer pressing forward. However,
he's teeing that right hand all the time now. He's confident with that right hand. He knows it worked. Look, he's just holding it there, waiting for him to come, and there it comes.
Now what he has to do is he has to be careful, because if he overextends just like he did there, Fuhrer coming up and under after changing levels.
Take that. He avoided it well. He went on the back foot, spun his guy into the corner there.
Now Fuhrer putting the pressure on, driving the shoulder through his man Webster, keeping him pinned, looking for a possible double leg takedown. However, the left arm is a little bit too high.
Team Rampage here, putting on a show, Lords of the Cage. Crowd getting really treated to a fantastic night of action here tonight.
Now what Fuhrer needs to do is he needs to put his head to the inside to be able to rip that leg up to the ceiling, putting Webster with his back on the mat. However, Webster's pushing away on the head and looking to throw shots.
Webster's planted his feet well. He's sticking his gravity down on top of him to stop him getting that takedown. Referee Lee Cantnell's going to pull him off the cage. Gavin Robinson put together some fantastic fights tonight. Crowd, oh, they're being really treated. They're really enjoying this, especially when the MMA guys are prepared to stand up and sling shots at each other. For those of you at home watching this on TV, Pierre, do you want to give them a idiot's guide to MMA?
Well, with mixed martial arts, it's basically it's a whole bunch of stuff put into a pot. What I mean that is you have all sorts of stand-up disciplines. You have Thai boxing, Taekwondo, Western style boxing mixed in with, again, another mixture of grappling. You have Sambo, you have Jiu-Jitsu, and now a lot of people in the mixed martial arts world no longer train just certain disciplines. They're picking and grabbing from anything that works, anything that has a high percentage.
If it works, use it.
Exactly. Anything else, throw it out of the toolbox.
It's almost identical to a street fight, this MMA. There's some rules in there, but basically anything goes as long as what are the illegal strikes? You want to run through that for anyone watching, Pierre?
Well, actually, believe it or not, since the early 90s, a lot of rules have been instituted. For example, there's no fish hooking. There's no trying to bend back your opponent's fingers. You can't check the oil, which means go into any other orifice. Of course, you can't attack to the spine. No elbows and a downward motion, meaning from that 12 to 6. No intentional spiking to the head or shots to the groin. So believe it or not, we've gotten a lot of rules and we've become a lot safer sport. And again, I think we're one of the fastest growing sports in the world, as evident by UCF, Lord of the Cage.
These two guys, as they come out for round two, of course, they're in the capable hands of a fantastic referee, Lee Catnell, very experienced brujitsu guy. And these two guys on the cage.
Now the referee is warning Matt Fuhrer about grabbing the cage.
Yeah, I saw him clinching there, Pierre.
Now Fuhrer, when he comes in for the shot, he needs to come behind some punches, something to hide the shot, because he's coming in from too far out with his arms spread wide open. And I tell you what, he's just asking to be hit with an uppercut or a knee, so he has to be careful.
Yeah, low shot in there, Pierre. Referee just giving him a second to gather himself from that shot.
Now Fuhrer's going to, again, he's not going to win the reach fight, the length fight, because Webster is a lot longer arm, lot longer limb, so he needs to break that distance down. Throw a couple shots, change level, and put him up against the fence.
Nose pouring with blood. It's not fazed your man in there.
Webster throwing the leather, straight shots. Now he drops it to the body.
Yeah,
he's got Fuhrer backed up, covering
those
up.
Right,
and he goes down.
Referee Lee Catnell has stopped this fight. That was a fantastic finish from Webster. Team Hazard are absolutely absolutely delighted with that result. They've trained Webster really hard for this fight, I know. And he let those hands go. I didn't think he had the energy to do that, Pierre, to be honest.
Well, he came out of nowhere with that. He had Fury on the back foot, which he had been doing consistently. And he had enough time to set it up, and he just exploded. And Fury, once he was on the back foot, covered up. He wasn't intelligently defending himself. The referee's going to stop it. Fury just didn't have any answer.
100% I backed the referee for that stoppage, by the way, Pierre.
Yeah, very good calls from the referee staff here tonight.
I think so. Fantastic fight card. Webber, we absolutely delighted with that opening fight. This is his first one he's had. He came out absolutely electric in the beginning, split the guy's nose. At the end of the fight, it was really turning either way, put him down in the corner and just executed some absolutely awesome shots on the button. The right hooks were landing right over the guard, straight through his chin, and that's that.
Well, let's not take anything away from Matt Fury. He knew he wasn't going to win the striking, so he did the smart thing. He was trying to, again, take his man down, push him up against the cage. However, it just wasn't his night. He showed great heart, great resiliency, and a very well-fought fight by both fighters.
After 59 seconds of the second round, your winner by way of ground and pound, Paul Webster! And a round of applause for his very game opponent in Matt Fuhrer. Please, ladies and gentlemen, make your way to the bar, get yourself a burger. We are coming at you in a couple of moments with the raffle.